Hello everybody, I want to make this video because I was like spending time with the Lord, and I'm a little bit emotional now, but I was spending time with the Lord. It's so beautiful. But, I want to read you guys Malachi, I think the first chapter. I think the first chapter is enough for now, but I do want to make the second one, the third chapter, and the fourth one too. I love the book of Malachi, my friends. I really love it. I can't deny it, but I want to share this video with you guys because you need to receive this blessing. And this blessing is just basically the jealousy of God, when God is jealous, okay? God gets jealous as children. He gets jealous. He's a jealous God, you know. And we must seek Him. We must be zealous and jealous for Him too. We must be zealous for what He stands. And we must be jealous for the blessings that He gives us, like we shouldn't give it to other people who are of the world. And they are just pretty much like you're casting your prayers before shrine. But this is not the subject of my reading. It's just, I want to share this with you just to show you guys how jealous and zealous God is for His people. So, this is how it goes. The burden of the word of the Lord to Israel by Malachi. He was a prophet. I have loved you, said the Lord. Yet ye say, wherein hast thou loved us? Was not Esau Jacob's brother, said the Lord? Yet I loved Jacob, and I hated Esau. I lay his mountains and his heritage waste for the dragons of the wilderness. Whereas Edom saith, we are impoverished, but we will return and build the desolate places. Doth, saith the Lord of hosts, they shall build, but I will throw down, and they shall call them the burden of wickedness, and the people against whom the Lord hath indignation forever. And your eyes shall see, and ye shall say, the Lord will be magnified from the border of Israel. A son honoreth his father, and a servant his master. If then I be a father, where is my honor? And if I be a master, where is my fear, said the Lord of hosts unto you, O priest that despise my name? And ye say, wherein have we despised thy name? Ye offer polluted bread upon mine altar, and ye say, wherein have we polluted thee? In that ye say, the table of the Lord is contemptible. And if ye offer the blind for sacrifice, is it not evil? And if ye offer the lame for and sick, is it not evil? Offer now unto the governor. Will he be pleased with thee, or accept thy person, said the Lord of hosts? And now I pray you, beseech God that He will be gracious unto us. This has been by your means. Will He regard your person, said the Lord of hosts? Who is there even among you that will shut the doors for naught? Neither do ye kindle fire on my altar, for naught. I have no pleasure in you, said the Lord of hosts. Neither will I accept an offering at your hand. For from the rising of the sun even unto the going down of the same, my name shall be great among the Gentiles. We're Gentiles, my friends. Praise the Lord God Almighty. Okay. For from the rising of the sun even unto the going down of the same, my name shall be great among the Gentiles, and in every place incense shall be offered unto my name, and a pure offering, for my name shall be great among the heathen, saith the Lord of hosts. But ye have profaned it, in that ye say, the table of the Lord is polluted, and the fruit thereof, even his meat, is contemptible. Ye said also, behold, what a weariness is it, and ye have snuffed at it, saith the Lord of hosts. And ye brought that which was stolen, and the lame and the sick doth ye brought an offering. Should I accept these of your hands, said the Lord of hosts? But cursed But cursed be the deceiver, which hath in his flock a male, and boweth, and sacrificeth unto the Lord a corrupt thing. For I am a great king. Oh yes, you are a great king, Lord God Almighty. Said the Lord of hosts, and my name is dreadful among the heathen. He repeats that again. My name is dreadful among the heathen. He's awesome. He's amazing. Thank you, my brothers and sisters, for watching this. God is awesome. Be zealous for Him. Be jealous for the little things that He gives you in terms of blessings. You know, He allows us to breathe every day, to bring Him glory and to work for Him, for His kingdom. Don't faint, because the battle is almost over. You know, the race is almost over. The Lord is coming soon to gather of His wheat into His barn, heaven. We're going to go into His home. This is why He says in Scripture, my Father's home, I have many houses. You know, I'm going to go and prepare a place for you. And where I am, I shall return and receive you unto myself. That's what's going to happen one day. And we're going to be in His barn. We're going to be in His barn forever. God bless you, brothers and sisters.